So to calculate these answers, I added up all of the entries in each row. So for example, in this row, I added up these numbers, divided by 5, and that gave me a result of 4.00 here, 9.00 here, and 16.02, or I've rounded here, for this last one. Now, look at this data. Isn't this beautiful? 1, 4, 9, 16, 0.02 though. Well, that 0.02 is sort of a bummer, but let's pretend it was just 16 for a second and see if there's any pattern. Well, 1, 4, 9, 16, I do see a pattern there. These are squares. One unit of time squared is 1. 2 squared is 4. 3 squared is 9, and 4 squared is 16. That's an incredible pattern. It seems like there may be some relationship between distance and the square of time. But this 16.02 is really bumming me out. Does it really mean that this pattern is false? Well, not necessarily. Because one thing we've forgotten to do so far is calculate error. In the previous unit, we talked about how to calculate the error of a single measurement. Maybe that measurement was measuring the length of the shadow of something. But now we have multiple measurements. We have 5 measurements for each of these calculated values. How do we calculate the error associated with multiple measurements?